After completing this chapter, the learner will understand the reasons for introduction of central cooling systems, know the operating principles of a central cooling system, know the general layout of a central cooling system. The amount of maintenance required for any cooling water system depends mainly on the materials used for the pipework and system components, and also on the quality of the water and water treatment used in the system. When using seawater for temperatures over 50 degrees Celsius, the level of corrosion and scale formation becomes unacceptable. The corrosion problem can, to some extent, be avoided by material selection, although the cost increases when using special alloys. Some of the materials, copper-based alloys, were mentioned in an earlier chapter. Material selection does not really help with scale formation, and the only way to reduce this is to use better quality water in the systems. This is the main reason for the development of central cooling systems, in which much of the traditional seawater system is replaced by freshwater circuits. This is now the preferred option, and it is likely that such a system is employed on your present vessel. You should check this out the next time you are in the engine room. A basic central cooling system has two interconnected freshwater circuits, one a high-temperature circuit and the other a low-temperature circuit, and a simple seawater circuit. The freshwater circuits are normally referred to as the HT and LT circuits, to denote high and low temperature respectively. The HT circuit serves the diesel engine jacket cooling water systems for the main and auxiliary engines. It can also be used for heating the fresh water generator. Typically, the system operates to give an outlet temperature from the engine of between 75 and 85 degrees Celsius. The HT circuit usually consists of two circulating pumps, which circulate the water through the main engine and auxiliary engine jackets. A three-way temperature control valve is provided, which connects to the LT system. Provision is also made to pass the HT water through the freshwater generator heat exchanger when required, with a suitable bypass facility when it is offline. A header tank and deaerator complete the system. Suitable valves for isolating the engines and pumps are provided for maintenance purposes. All cooling requirements other than the main and auxiliary engine jackets are met by the LT circuit. This includes cooling for the main and auxiliary engine lubricating oil and charge air. Other machinery served by the LT system includes air compressors and refrigeration and air conditioning compressors and condensers. Typically, the LT system operates with a temperature of about 37 degrees Celsius. The system usually comprises two circulating pumps and a number of heat exchangers. The heat exchangers include those for cooling lubricating oil and air for the diesel engines, the air compressors, and refrigerating and air conditioning equipment, as well as two seawater cooled central coolers. A three-way temperature control valve used in bypass diverter mode controls the fresh water flow through the central coolers. The LT system is connected to the HT system via the three-way mixing valve and a return connection. Temperature control of the HT system is achieved by a three-way valve used as a mixing valve. The sensor for controlling this valve is usually positioned at the main engine jacket water outlet or the return line to the circulating pumps. Constant engine outlet temperature is achieved by mixing water from the LT circuit into the HT circuit via this three-way valve. As the HT water temperature rises at the engine outlet due to increased engine power, the sensor detects the rise and sends a signal to the controller. Here it is compared to the set point and a corrective signal is sent to the control valve, which moves to allow some of the LT water to mix with the HT water, so reducing the temperature. There may be additional individual temperature control for the auxiliary engines using thermostatically controlled valves. Temperature control of the LT circuit is achieved by a three-way valve used to control the flow through the central coolers in a bypass arrangement. The sensor for the valve is positioned downstream from the point at which the return from the central coolers re-enters the LT circuit. As the temperature of the system starts to rise due to increased thermal load, the sensor detects the rise and sends a signal to the controller. Here it is compared to the set point, and a corrective signal is sent to the control valve, which moves to allow some of the LT water to pass to the coolers, so reducing the temperature. Any further increase in thermal load on the system will cause the valve to divert more flow to the coolers. In some systems, there are additional three-way valves to control temperatures of the individual services by bypassing the primary fluids at the relevant heat exchangers. Minimum temperature for the LT circuit may be achieved by using split range control to control a heating unit in the system. The seawater circuit for a central cooling system is very simple. It usually consists of two seawater suction strainers, two or more circulating pumps, and two heat exchangers, the central coolers. These heat exchangers are usually of the plate type. The material used for the pipework is generally high-quality copper-based alloy, although some systems use stainless steel. These materials reduce maintenance requirements as they are resistant to corrosion, and as there is so little pipework in the system, the cost is moderate. The plates for the heat exchanger are also made from high-quality material, which is resistant to corrosion. Stainless steel or titanium is often chosen, since the high strength allows very thin plates to be used, which improves heat transfer. The central cooling system can be adapted to provide cooling or heating for most of the machinery on board. The LT system can be used to provide the secondary fluid for many of the cooling requirements, such as air compressor, heat exchangers, and oil coolers. The HT system can be used as a source of heating. We have already seen that it can be used as the heat source for the freshwater generator. It can also be used to heat domestic water and to preheat machinery such as the main and auxiliary diesel engines. The seawater circuit can be used to provide preheated feed for the freshwater generator and also the cooling requirements for any systems requiring direct seawater cooling to achieve lower temperatures than can be achieved by the LT water. By doing this, the number of subsystems can be reduced and the overall plant simplified. In this section, we have looked at the arrangement of a central cooling system. You should now understand the reasons for having such a system and be aware of the subsystems that make up the main system. You should also have an understanding of how the system temperatures are controlled. In the next chapter, we will look at the maintenance requirements of cooling water systems, and in particular, how we can treat the systems to minimize this requirement.